Hey there, Coreum holders. We can tell by the Coreum price action today that tomorrow will be an exciting day. It is because the first round of airdrop distribution from the March 24th snapshot is finally here. This means you have a chance to earn rewards just by holding your Coreum tokens. But that's not all. As a Coreum holder, you also have the chance to participate in the consensus as a validator or delegate your tokens by staking. This will help secure the Coreum network and earn you even more Coreum tokens as an incentive. In this tutorial, I'll guide you through the step-by-step process of staking your tokens and start earning rewards. So let's get started. The first step is to create or import your wallet. For this tutorial, we will use the Leap wallet. Head over to the leapwallet.io and hit the download button. Select the platform that you're using. So for me, I will select the one for the Brave browser. Once you've selected your platform, follow the installation process. After installing the Leap wallet, open the app and either create a new wallet or import your existing one. If you're creating a new wallet, make sure to write down your seed phrase or private key. I personally like to write down my seed phrase or private key on a physical notebook. This way, I can ensure that my information is safely stored offline and easily accessible whenever I need it. This is important because it will be the only way to access your wallet in case you lose your device or forget your password. Since your Leap wallet is where you will be staking and receiving rewards, you might want to connect it to your ledger. This option is available once you've created a Leap wallet. It will be on the top menu in the middle where the item reads Wallet 1. If you want to know how to connect your ledger to your Leap wallet, I can show you the steps in another tutorial. But for now, let's move on to the next step. Now that we've created our wallet, we need to connect it to the Coreum network. To connect to the network, simply press the icon on the top right-hand corner of the menu bar. You can either scroll down and search or type in Coreum mainnet on the search bar. You'll know that you are on the Coreum mainnet when you see the Coreum logo on the top right-hand corner. Now that you have a Coreum mainnet address, you're ready to proceed to the next step, which is bridging your Coreum tokens through SOLO DEX. We're halfway there! So to bridge your Coreum tokens, head over sologenic.com and log into SOLO DEX. You can either transfer Coreum tokens to your SOLO wallet or connect your ZOM wallet. Once you're on SOLO DEX, go to the top menu and select Bridge. Paste in your Coreum wallet address that we just created using Leap wallet. You will have to sign the transaction on your ZOM or SOLO phone app to finalize bridging. I did a test amount which took about 10 minutes, so don't panic if you don't see your tokens right away. Hey, now that we have bridged our Coreum tokens to our Leap wallet, we are at the final step where the real fun begins. We're ready to put our Coreum to work by staking and start earning rewards. First thing we need to do before staking our Coreum is to choose a reputable validator. When selecting a validator, it is essential to choose one who is not only technically competent but also actively engaged in the community. Look for validators who participate in community forums such as Reddit, YouTube, Twitter, and other social platforms. This will ensure that the validator is personally invested in the project and has a good understanding of its goals and objectives. Also, active community engagement suggests that the validator is reliable and transparent, making it more likely that they will prioritize the network's security and stability. It is also a good idea to stake with 2 or 3 validators to hedge your risk of slashing or losing all your tokens to a hacker or bad actor. For those interested, there will be a separate video to provide tips for choosing validators. Once you've chosen a validator, you can start staking. Go to the Stake tab on the bottom navigator, hit the Stake button, select the validator you want to stake with, and enter the amount you want to stake. Select Preview to review the details and make sure everything is correct. Then select Stake to send the transaction. Keep in mind that your tokens will be locked during the delegation period, and it will take 7 days for them to become available again after you decide to undelegate them. If you want to switch to a different validator, you can redelegate your tokens without waiting for the unbonding period only for the first time. For subsequent redelegation, we'll have to wait for the 7 days unbonding period. Congratulations! You've successfully staked your Coreum tokens using Leap Wallet. Now you're all set to start earning rewards and contributing to the security of the Coreum network. Just remember to keep your seed phrase or private key safe, do not share them with anyone you do not know, and stay updated on any changes or development to the Coreum network. If you made it this far into the tutorial, you're awesome. So here are two bonus tips for you. Bonus tip number one, unstaking your tokens. If you want to try other validators and want to unstake your tokens, go to the stake tab, select the validator you want to undelegate from, enter the amount you want to undelegate, and hit review to make sure everything is correct. Then select unstake to send the transaction. Bonus tip number two, claiming your rewards. If you've earned any rewards from staking and want to claim them, go to the stake tab located at the bottom and check the your rewards section. Hit the claim button to claim your rewards. Review the transaction details and select claim rewards to send the transaction. That's it for today's tutorial. I hope you found it helpful. Remember, staking can be a great way to earn rewards and contribute to the security of the Coreum network. Stay tuned for more updates on Coreum and happy staking!